Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Joel Rosen. I am the Adrenal Fatigue Recovery Ninja. And today I wanted to talk to you about a question that was posed to me in my Facebook group, my private Facebook group. If you're watching this and you're not a member, I'll post the link so you can be a member of that. And if you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you subscribe to my channel because I post a lot of questions and videos and answers to your questions. So the main question I got was, is there a relationship between leaky gut and diverticulitis? And I would say absolutely there is. The main thing is the causes and the effects, basically. So think about leaky gut as you have tight junctions that hold the GI the GI lining together, where your absorption goes through these tight junctions in order to get into the bloodstream. And these tight junctions are held together by signaling proteins that slightly open up when signaled to allow the really ideally digested particles to get into your bloodstream and your immune system. And whereas diverticulitis in the extent of the GI tract, you have little folds, and in those folds, we call them small pouches, and that gets inflamed. And what you're gonna find is it's a matter of perspective, meaning diverticulitis is not gonna be where the small junctions or the tight junctions are, which open and sort of part C's to allow the foods that are really greatly digested to get in. They're gonna be along the entire length of the tract where there are small folds. However, it's the same things that cause the inflammation in one part that can cause the inflammation in other parts. And that's typically gonna be a result of environmental toxins. So you have so much pesticides and GMOs and hybridization and chemicals and modulators and inflammation sources like pathogens and heavy metals that is ultimately going to cause these inflammatory responses, whether it's in the folds or if it's in the tight junctions. However, in the medical model, they don't believe, typically in the allopathic model, they've never heard of leaky gut, although the research does talk about intestinal permeability. I don't think it's even a thought nowadays for those in the know that read the actual journals that are being produced by allopathic doctors that show that there is a phenomena of tight junction loosening up, and zonulin and actin and occludin and myosin and all of these signaling proteins actually having antibodies and what we call them predictive antibodies that give us an extrapolation and allow us to infer that there is an intestinal permeability. But the same things are going to cause a matter of perspective. The same inflammatory triggers are going to cause a leaky, that can cause a leaky gut, can cause the diverticulitis. And I didn't even mention food reactivity. So foods, the proteins in corn, egg, soy, gluten, dairy, and other grain-like nutrients can really cause an inflammatory mechanism. But here's the thing that I would tell you that you can address both of them is in what we call the four R's. So repairing the tight junctions or repairing the inflammatory destruction of those small pouches as well. Glutamine is a great nutrient, and it's not just going to say, okay, we're not going to go to the small folds or the pouches, we're just going to go. It doesn't work that way. It's going to go all over. So glutamine, slippery elm, chamomile, a lot of different nutrients like that can be very, very helpful. Then we have restoring. So when you have inflammation in the GI tract, you're going to have decreased ability to secrete gastric juices and pancreatic enzymes, hydrochloric acid, lipases, digestive enzymes to break down your carbs, proteins, and fats. So we want to help restore that. Reinoculate, I mean, obviously we want to make sure we get enough healthy bacterias that are going to help with signaling and modulating and converting and absorbing and assimilating. Those are going to be really helpful. And then lastly, removing. So we want to remove the debris, you want to remove the exposure, you want to remove the pathogens, you want to kill and eliminate a lot of these things. And that's going to be true for diverticulitis and or leaky gut. So anyways, I hope that was helpful for you. My name is Dr. Joel Rosen. I am the Adrenal Fatigue Recovery Ninja, and I look forward to helping you end your adrenal fatigue nightmare. Thank you so much.